Hello everyone, welcome to this introductory series of Salesforce Commerce Cloud. In this series, we will be covering different aspects of e-commerce, and also we'll be trying to get familiar with the Salesforce Commerce Cloud platform and its capabilities. When we're talking about the e-commerce development, be it business to consumer or business to business, Salesforce is one of the key players in the industry, providing such support. But what is Salesforce Commerce Cloud? So if we try to define Salesforce Commerce Cloud in simple terms, it is a software as a service solution. What a software as a service solution is, basically a cloud-based software delivery model that allows end user to access software application over the internet. Previously, it was known as Demandware, but since the acquisition of Demandware by Salesforce, it has been renamed to Commerce Cloud. And it provides you with a seamless integration across different third parties. When you are trying to sell something digitally over the internet, it's not something which can be taken care of by a single application, but it requires multiple third parties or stakeholders involvement as well. So let's say if you are trying to sell some product on the internet, the product information or maybe the category information related to that product might have been flowing from a different system known as PIM, your product information management system. Similarly, if you're talking about the customer relationship, that's a different system, which is your CRM. Or maybe the order has been placed, now the order lifecycle begins. The order goes through different stages, like it has been shipped, then it gets delivered, then it takes to the completion. That is something which is even taken care of by the order management system. Or let's say if you're talking about the checkout process, when you're trying to make a purchase, you're providing the payment specific information, so the payment authorization for the fraud check or the normal authorization as well is being taken care of by payment gateways. So we see, and when we are trying to sell something digitally, there are multiple third parties or the stakeholders which are involved in that particular business. And Salesforce Commerce Cloud basically provides a seamless integration across different third parties and different channels. So again, if we try to simply put into perspective what Salesforce Commerce Cloud is, it is something, it is a platform, it's a SaaS based solution which helps create a website, interactive website for the e-commerce business. Now, since we have been talking a lot about the e-commerce, let's take a brief look at what exactly e-commerce business is. So what do we mean by e-commerce? So e-commerce is nothing but electronic commerce, which we used to do before in a physical format, in a physical store. But now that has been replaced by a virtual store. And all the stakeholders which are involved in that particular process are involved digitally. So in simple terms, e-commerce is nothing but doing the same transactions electronically or digitally that we were doing before at a nearby store or the shopping mall physically. Now, coming back to Salesforce Commerce Cloud, we now know that Salesforce Commerce Cloud is a platform which provides support for creating the e-commerce websites. Now, let's say I want to create a website for myself, my own business, and I approach Salesforce for the solution. What Salesforce gives me is a box. Just to put take a overview, overall picture of the architecture, just take a bird's eye view of the architecture itself and put it in a simple format, we can say it's a box which is known as a realm. This is what I have got from Salesforce. Now let's say if we are talking about accessing any website, there are multiple resources involved. Let's say if you're trying to hit google.com or any other website that you're trying to access, the request goes and tries to hit the server, and then server performs some logical operations based on the kind of request that you are making, and it provides you with the response. Same thing happens with the Salesforce as well. So this realm that we have got, it in the background, it has multiple servers. It could be your web servers, application servers, database servers just to fetch the data, or the storage, the kind of like whatever transactions that we are doing, or the product information or any other kind of information they are trying to store in this particular storage. So this is something which is taken care of by Salesforce Commerce Cloud itself. It's an automated process and nothing has to be done from the developer side on this part. But apart from that, what else is there in the realm which the developer has to take care of? And it basically consists of two different kind of instance groups. One is your PIGs, which stands for primary instance group, and the SIGs, which stands for the secondary instance group. Now, what exactly PIGs and SIGs are? It's nothing but a collection of sandboxes. Now, what a sandbox is, we'll come to that part later, but let's take a look at PIGs first. Now, when we talk about primary instance group, it's nothing but it's a collection of three sandboxes: staging, development, and production. Production being the live instance where the actual site resides. Development is, it's a bit confusing name, but don't get confused. It's not something which is being used by a developer team, but it's something which is used by the testing team, and just to make sure that everything before going to the live instance is working fine. So it's actually a replica of production, and it's sometimes it's called as a pre-prod environment. Now let's try to understand, when we are trying to sell something online or having an e-commerce website, it requires multiple decisions to be taken by different teams or different parties involved in that. Let's say if you're trying to sell something online, sales team is there who is analyzing the complete sales data and just trying to introduce some kind of promotion or some other campaign just to make sure the sales are high in the next cycle. There's a merchandising team who's involved just to make sure the content or the images or the video or meet some other legal policies or some other kind of static data which is present on the website. Just they're monitoring it and they're trying to make it in a way that it's more customer engaging. They're able to relate it to in a better way. There's a design team which is involved to make sure that the customer the user experience on the website across different pages or the devices is smooth. Then there's a technical team who's taking care of all these requirements and translating into logical way just to make sure that all the features those are requested are present on the website. So there are multiple teams involved when we are talking about selling something online. So staging, it's the most critical sandbox, and it is the one which consists of all the data and the code. So what I mean by data is all the teams, like the sales team who will be responsible for creating the promotions, merchandising team who will be responsible for creating the content, or the design team who will be analyzing the pattern and the customer experience. So everybody is doing the same, all their operations on the staging instance. So this is the most critical instance where all the data related to merchandising resides. Now, when the development team is working on the sandboxes, they want to have, or the quality assurance, if we talk about the quality assurance, they want to take a look at everything which is about to go to production. So that is something which is being done on the development instance. So all the end-to-end testings that we do, all the integration testing, everything happens on the development instance. And it is actually exact replica of the live instance. So production is the last stage where everything goes. Now, when we talk about moving everything, so just try to understand, everything goes to stage first. And from stage, it moves to development. And development, it's validated by the QA team. Once we get a go ahead on development, it then moves from stage to production. So it's a one-way channel, like things will be moving from staging either on development or production. So what do I mean by moving? How do we replicate the data or the code part? That is something we'll take a look at. But just to give you an overview of how the data and the code flows from stage to development or stage to production. So that's how it happens. And this is something which is part of your primary instance group. Now, as we know that the realm consisted of primary instance group and the secondary instance groups. Primary instance group is the most critical one because that is something which enables you to move things to the live instance. And just before that, when they are validating or being validated on the developer instance. But how does a developer work on the specific task or creates a feature? And then that goes to staging, and from their stage, it moves to either on development or production instance. So that is something which happens in the SIGs. SIG is basically your secondary instance groups, and it consists of sandboxes. Sandbox is actually, you can consider it as a GUI or a platform which allows you to connect both data and the code just to make sure that it is visible in the correct format on the website. We'll take a look at the sandbox, but before that, let's try to understand how many kind of sandboxes we have. Previously, we used to have legacy sandboxes, which were like initially created by demandware and been used by Salesforce for a longer time. But nowadays, we are getting the on-demand sandboxes, which is a better format of the SaaS. As software solution itself is a on-demand thing. So on-demand sandbox is something that you can directly request from Salesforce to be created for you. You can use it. So it's basically help you pay based on the usage of the sandbox itself. Now let's take a look at the sandbox. What exactly a sandbox is. So that's how a sandbox looks like. You can see multiple components are there. Here you can see the merchant tools. Here you have the administration. It gives you an option to select a site. So when we talk about a sandbox, or you can refer to a sandbox as a business manager tool as well. So sandbox is nothing but a business manager tool. In this sandbox, you can create multiple sites. So that's why it gives you an option for selecting a site. Merchant tools is something which is there to make sure the merchandising team is able to perform all the actions they are trying to do. Administration is something which is at the organization level. Don't worry about these different menu options. We'll be taking a look at them when we are going through the sandbox. And we'll be having a hands-on session on that as well. Storefront is something which is, if you click on this button, you'll see what exactly the website looks like. So it's like a web interface. So that's how a sandbox looks like. And if you want to give a try, if you want to take a look at how exactly the website looks, you can just go to this particular link. So this is the URL for the production site Genesis, which is provided by Salesforce Commerce Cloud. It's a dummy website which gives you a glimpse of how exactly the system works and what kind of actions you can perform over there. I would really recommend you to just go through this particular link. I'll post this link in the video description as well. And just go through different category navigation from here. You can create your account as well here. Mini cart option is there. Just try to add some products to the cart. Look at the checkout behavior, what kind of options you're getting, shipping, billing, card information. Similarly, if you scroll down, you'll be seeing the footer of the website. We'll be seeing different sections as well. On the top, you can see it's a banner which gives you the promotional content. And similarly, there's the search box. So there are multiple modules which are involved when we are talking about these e-commerce websites. And so as we were talking about, this production instance is actually a part of PIG, primary instance group. Similarly, if you replace this particular keyword production with either staging or development, you'll be landing on different instances. So for example, I replaced production with the development and then staging. So these are the URLs that we get, and even these URLs are functional. So if you try to hit development hyphen site genesis and this complete URL or staging.demandware.net, so these URLs as well are functional. And if you access these URLs, you'll see this particular toolkit on the top left corner. So this toolkit is not available on the production instance. Usually you get it on staging, development, or the SIGs. And it basically provides you insights of what's happening on the website. So if you go through development of the staging instance for site genesis, you'll see if you click in this particular toolkit, you'll see these options. It like the content information provides you with the information about what kind of content asset or the content slot is being used for that particular section. Similarly, if you click on the page information, it provides you with the information of which template or the code template is being used to render that particular section of the page. Cache information is also very critical. It helps you understand the caching behavior on the website, like which component is cached and for how long, so it doesn't have any impact on the performance side. Similarly, the search information or the request log, you can just directly access it. Some of the modules, when you try to access, you may be getting redirected to the business manager or the sandbox URL, which you may not be able to access. But just take a look at the overall picture and just try to understand and go through the flow, like what kind of features are being provided by Salesforce Commerce Cloud. In the next video, we'll be taking a look at the components. What kind of components are involved and how we integrated with the existing sandboxes and how we convert the data and the code into a functional website. That is something that we'll be taking care of as part of the next video. I hope you guys found this video to be informative. In case you have any questions related to this session, please feel free to reach out to sfcc.queries@gmail.com, or you can also post your questions in the comments. I'll try to address them there itself. Thank you.